I was introduced to the video game realm a tad later than most other people. For most, if not all of my early childhood, was isolated from other kids, and I had next to no social interactions. My days were spent in a prison-like school, and my nights rotted away with mind-numbing TV. Life was dull and boring, and all I had were my stuffed animals and cheap plastic toys to talk to. That's when I got a GameCube. It was early Christmas of 2003, I believe. I was overjoyed at having my own video game station. It came with the games Super Mario Sunshine, Pac-Man World 2, and Pokemon Channel. Each of those games still hold a special place in my heart today. As soon as the GameCube was set up, I was ready to go, and I started playing immediately. The first game I played was Super Mario Sunshine. This game got me hooked into the Mario series after playing it for hours straight. And finally finding a level I just couldn't get past, I turned to Pac-Man World 2. Amazingly though, I got stuck on level 2. Infuriated that I couldn't find a way even though the answer was right in front of my eyes, I quit and started playing my first ever Pokemon game. Pokemon Channel. As soon as I turned the game on, I knew the game was going to be different from the other two. It didn't take long for me to fall in love with the game. When the time came to name my Pikachu, I unwittingly named it BRVR. That's short for brother. What compelled me to do such a strange nickname is that it didn't even sound like the shortened version of brother. I'll never know, but regardless, I still enjoyed playing. There's no way for me to describe the love I felt towards this game. It was everything I've ever dreamed of. In this game, I had a friend I could play with. It all took place in the Pokemon world, which I already loved before I got Pokemon Channel. I could watch TV with my best friend, BRVR, go fishing with him, play tic-tac-toe with him, talk to other Pokemon with him, grow a garden with him, build a snowman with him, explore the ancient ruins with him, play musicals with him, sit around campfires and tell stories with him, gaze at the stars with him. All the things I never experienced in real life, I was able to do in this virtual world with BRVR, this best friend I've never had. I was obviously over-addicted to the game, but I had nothing else to do. So instead, I put all of it into this game, oblivious to all the things happening in the real world. I preferred to live my life in this Pokemon fantasy with my best friend. BRVR, we'll just call him Brother from now on, seemed like more of a virtual animated 3D model, forced to do his actions based on the programming of the game. But he seemed real to me. If I was ever sad one day, he would appear to look and act depressed too. If I was ever angry, he would show and express my rage during the play of the game too. If I needed something to cheer me up, he would act silly and leap at me or do other idiotic things. Later on, I grew older, wiser, and just assume all these strange events never really happened. When I was younger, I just simply imagined it. But it was still fun to pretend he was real. As the years passed, I got a lot more games. I acquired a Game Boy, which came along with it more Pokemon games, where I could have more than just a single Pikachu. My interests also floated to different series, like Mario or Sonic. After playing Pokemon Channel so many times, and doing things over and over again, it started to get a bit boring. I started playing it less and less, and other games more and more. But I still gave Pokemon Channel a play every now and then. Eventually, I changed schools, and my whole life changed. I was moved from a private Christian school to a public school, and my eyes were opened to reality. I started to learn new things about real life, which helped me enjoy it more. People weren't mean and cruel to me. They would greet me when I passed them in the halls. I discovered I could do more than just play video games. I could draw. There were thousands of songs I could listen to, and my grades, they just started dramatically rising. But the best part of it all was that I got a new friend. A real friend. One who was flesh and blood. She was funny, and she helped me get used to school, and she could be someone I could talk to, besides my parents. We both had the same immature mockery, and we would mock everything and anything possible. We had similar minds. I finally had a best friend. While I started to grow in both body and mind, Pokemon Channel was slowly forgotten. Moved on to greater and better games. Almost all things I could do in the game I was able to do in real life now. Brother was replaced by my real life best friend. He and the game had become obsolete, forgotten, on a dusty shelf in the dark corner of a room. For the next couple of years of my life, it was golden. Each day, I would learn something new, and I had a ton of fun with my best friend. I made a few other friends, too, but no one could top my best friend. Every now and then, I'd get a new game, get some money, go do something with my best friend, draw something, listen to music. I never wished for anything more. But remember this, good things never last. Eventually, I had to move. I protested and threw a fit, but to no avail, trying to stop the tears from falling down my face. I told my best friend goodbye on the last day of school. For my next few nights, I cried myself to sleep at my new house. But eventually, I stopped, having one of my main reasons to live, and life ripped away, tore a hole in my heart that never completely healed. But the pain eventually became less and less. I still had contact with my best friend, though. We both had YouTube accounts, and we'd talk to each other over the internet. We'd call each other, too. We'd have sleepovers sometimes, see a movie together, but it hurt to not have her at school anymore. I made some new friends at my school. Even more than my old school, but none of them were as funny as my best friend. No one could replace her. Just when I thought I could get used to this lifestyle, one of the most dreadful things happened. For her sake, I won't post what my friend did, but she did something horrible, and my mom refused to let me speak or see her ever again. My heart was utterly smashed into thousands of pieces. I felt like I had nothing to live for. My best friend, and what felt like my only friend, was gone forever. I now sank and sunk back into my old habits, playing video games and isolating myself from the rest of the world. I didn't like to go out anymore. I refused to leave my room except to go to school, eat, or use the restroom. And I visit my dad every other weekend. Now that my best friend has been snatched away from me, that I didn't do anything in real life anymore, I needed something to replace them. Searching through my ancient shelf of old games, I pulled up Pokemon Channel. I brushed off the dust of the cover. It felt like an eternity since I've gazed upon this game. I inserted the game disc into the GameCube, grabbed my controller, and I awaited to greet my old friend, brother. A tear fell down my cheek as memories flooded back while I stared at the screen. After a moment of soaking in nostalgia, I selected continue. I eagerly selected yes when the information appeared, currently asking if it was correct. As the transition Pokeballs rolled across the screen, I just couldn't wait to see brother again. When the transition was over, I appeared in my room. The normal cutscene where Pikachu was asleep on top of the shelf didn't display. But at this moment, I had almost completely forgotten about that. The only thing on my mind was brother. As I searched around my room, he wasn't anywhere in sight. A Delibird delivers the goods you buy from the shop. I smiled warmly at the sight. I remembered I bought something from the channel almost every day when I was younger. I thought I must have bought something the last time I played and completely forgot about it. Curious about what was in the delivery, I eagerly headed for the door. A deep moaning sound stopped me before I could reach the door. I turned to the screen and saw brother climbing out from under the bed. He looked up at me depressed. I had never seen him climb out from underneath the bed before, except when he's searching for the Pokemon Mini in the beginning of the game. When he turned and saw the shocked expression on his face like it normally should. "Hey brother, it's me," I whispered, even though I knew he couldn't hear me. Instead of a joyous look and cheering, he acquired an infuriated look on his face. I was a bit confused as to why he was angry, but before I could ponder the subject, a Delibird called again from the door. Banishing the whole incident from my thoughts, I turned and opened the door. I was comforted when the Delibird handed over the box, and brother smiled and waved as the Delibird flew off. A package arrived, with merchandise from the shop. I quickly pressed A to see what the message was. I wondered what was inside, as brother leaned inside the box and took out the items. "You got a Pikachu TVZ. The Pikachu TVZ has been displayed. A menacing and quite gruesome looking Pikachu TV was set up in the replacement of my old Voltorb TV. It looked like a Pikachu head facing towards you with its jaws wide open, and its mouth was the TV screen, and its fangs hanging over the top and the bottom. It looked like the skin was tearing and ripping apart places, like the TV screen was too large for its mouth. I was a bit shocked at how scary the TV looked. "You got red wallpaper, Z." The wallpaper has been displayed. I gasped when I saw what the wallpaper was when it was put up. It was a dark, red-like, dried blood. There was Pikachus with sick, twisted smiles that repeated all across it. They each were bright and red, and fleshy, and drawn blood. I was worried. "You got Pikachu Doll Z." The doll's been displayed. I winced with fear when I saw the morbid Pikachu placed on top of one of the shelves. It had been the same eerie grin as the Pikachu wallpaper, except the long fangs and its eyes were small, red, and dilated. The tip of its tail curved inwards like a hook, and it had sharp-looking claws. Numerous dried streaks of blood ran. "You got Pikachu Doll Z." The doll has been displayed. "You got Pikachu Doll Z." The doll's been displayed. "You got Pikachu Doll Z." The doll's been displayed. The same sequence happened over and over until the entire room was filled with disturbing Pikachu dolls. They replaced all the other ones. Brother got up and looked around the room. He nodded in satisfaction and walked towards the TV. I sat in my chair, stricken with fear. Even though it had been years since I've played this game, I knew these items were never in it. A threatening and commanding call came from Pikachu. He was standing in front of the TV, giving me a glare. I knew he wanted me to go over there. I walked to the TV and turned it on. It opened a report channel like normal, but to my horror, the screen looked like it had blood dripping down it. I changed the channels, and they all looked that way. I quickly opened up my diary, which in the game was the start menu, and I clicked the TVS tab. I chose Voltorb TV, but as soon as I did, my diary closed without pressing B, and Brother was staring at me with a threatening glare and shook his head disapprovingly. Brother turned back to the TV and changed it to the Fortune Channel. This channel seemed normal except for the blood dripping down the screen. "Choose your cookie." The words drifted from the bottom of the TV screen. I chose the top one like I always do. The cookie floated down the Chansey's hands and it crackled open. "Do you really want to know your fortune?" The words appeared on the screen. I froze with fear. Something about that fortune seemed eerie. It appeared that the Chansey on the screen was laughing. Brother changed the channel again. He changed it to the relaxation channel instead of the flurry. What greeted me was morbid Pikachus that looked just like the dolls jumping over the fence. I quickly pressed B and went back to the center of the room. Normally, Brother would turn around and motion me back to watch it with him, but this time he didn't seem to care. I walked over my old painting. A beautifully colored Jirachi surrounded a cute Pikachu border hung against the wall. I sighed with relief. At least one thing was still normal. I took a few moments to stare at the old painting, mostly just because I didn't want to look at the gruesome wallpaper or horrifying dolls. Brother was looking at the painting too. Chills went through my spine as that message appeared. Even though it was normal for Pikachu to stare at your painting with you, I pressed B, and sure enough, Brother was standing in front of the painting. It seemed like he had a sad expression, like he was remembering long-lost memories. He turned to me, still with the same depressed expression. He looked like he was about to cry. I felt sorry for him. I wished there was something I could do to cheer him up. Brother walked up to me and asked me a question, which is normal for your Pikachu to ask you a question every now and then. But what made my blood chill was when he asked, "Brother wants to know if you still love him." It had an O for yes and an X for no option. Brother has never asked that before. I immediately clicked O. He smiled, then bent over laughing. I was a bit confused as to why he was having a laughing fit. When he was done laughing, he looked back up at me with an evil smile. A message box appeared at the top of the screen. Brother knows you're lying. He turned back to watch TV. By this point, I didn't know what to do anymore. I knew for sure that this wasn't supposed to be happening. I thought that maybe if I restarted my GameCube, everything would go back to normal. I got up and reached for the restart button. But when I pressed it, nothing happened. I pressed it a second time, and still nothing. The game cannot be reset right now. A message appeared on the screen. My heart stopped beating for a second. After dumbly staring at the screen for a solid minute, I sat back down and decided I would continue playing. Might as well see where it goes, I whispered to myself. I just looked around the room for a minute. Other than the wallpaper, dolls, and TV, everything seemed to be the same. I tried to smile while looking at the old Pokemon mini and posters, but I couldn't bring myself to. Normally, cute and cheerful music seemed to make my room more dark and disturbing, as if all the morbid dolls had their eyes focused on me, like they were about to reach out and grab me, then slowly tear apart and devour my flesh. Brother wants to go outside, the message appeared from top of the screen. Before I could do anything though, Brother went outside, and the game forced me to follow him. My breath caught my throat when I went outside. The sky was blood red and the clouds were dark. Strewn all across the lawn were dead Pokemon corpses. I couldn't tell what most of them were, that's how torn up they were. Most of their limbs were torn off, their faces shredded, entrails everywhere. I felt sick. I was about to throw up. Brother circled around them, then turned to me, gave me an evil grin. He walked up to me and asked a question. Brother wants to know if you like what he's done to the place. I immediately clicked X. His sick grin deepened even more. He walked over his skitty corpse and threw it at me. Its body parts broke all over and flew everywhere as it bounced all over the screen. After many agonizing minutes of being forced to watch Brother toy with dead body parts, he walked over to the garden. When we stepped into the garden, two plants were fully grown. Instead of fruits, they had grown Pikachu heads. Brother plucked one of them and started to slowly eat it. My lunch started to rise up my throat, but I forced it back down. I tried to turn away from the gruesome sight, but something glued my eyes to the screen. After taking his time, Brother walked over and ate another head. Once he was done, he cast me a wicked smile and leaped out the garden. Again, I was forced to follow him. Brother has apparently done messing around outside and went straight inside. I was hoping he was done and we would just stay inside. I now much preferred the morbid dolls over the body parts, but he wasn't done showing me the world he had created. Almost as soon as we went inside, Brother went immediately to the back door. Guess who was forced to follow yet again? Me. When we went outside, there weren't many corpses, much to my relief, but the sky was still an ominous blood red. When I tried to go back inside, he wouldn't let me. Brother would just turn me and give a disapproving shake of his head, so I was forced to stand there. The Viridian Forest bus pulled up, and Brother walked up to it, without even clicking on it. The transition played normally, the bus riding over the map to Viridian Forest, but when we got there, the whole forest was on fire. Dead Pokemon were lying everywhere as the trees wildly burned, their bodies charred black by the flames. Brother seemed unaffected by the blazing fire. He skipped over the patch of mushrooms. They looked like they were bleeding. Brother ate one without asking permission, gave a satisfied nod when he was done. Then he ran over to the bell that starts the Pokemon concert. Instead of Brother being surrounded by Clefairies, he was surrounded by morbid Pikachu plushies. Using the bells, they played most haunting melodies. I was awestruck. It sounded so beautiful yet so horrifying. It was high-pitched and made my ears ache, but I was in a trance and I couldn't think to turn the volume down. After what seemed like years, the play was finally over. Glancing around, Brother seemed satisfied with the burning forest and headed back towards the bus. Again, I was forced to stand outside my house while I awaited for the next horrors Brother would inflict upon my eyes. I thought he would want to take the Mount Snowfall bus, but he had other ideas. He just let that bus pass on by. Instead, he decided to take the bus to Cobalt Beach next. Same simple transition, same horrifying scene. The beach was littered with pieces of corpses of Pokemon you would normally find roaming around. The ocean looked like blood. Floating was more Pokemon body parts. It then became apparent that Brother didn't like other Pokemon. We then played a game of tic-tac-toe instead of rocks. We used internal organs for the pieces. Brother beat me by a long shot. Although that was because I couldn't think straight, using entrails as X's and O's as, you know, he laughed when he beat me, like this was normal and supposed to be happening. Then for a brief moment, a look of regret and sadness swept over his face. I felt a longing to reach out and comfort him, so I used the C-stick to pet him. But as soon as the cursor touched him, his normal, infuriated, and demented look came back. He ran off over the fishing area with a little person. Brother stood on his rock and threw out his fishing line into the ocean, waiting for a nibble. I did nothing, for there was nothing I could do. But he turned and gave me a menacing glare, like I was supposed to be helping him. That's when I remembered the bait. I clicked on the jar labeled bait, but instead of the chocolate glazed donut, it was a rotting brain. It was falling apart and covered in greenish brown mold, yet it was still throbbing. I quickly tossed it into the ocean. Shortly afterwards, Brother caught something on the line. With a great yank, the creature came flying out of the ocean. I swear to God, this creature shall forever haunt my dreams. It looked like an oversized dark purple Magikarp, but it was foaming out of the mouth, while a green acidic blood poured out from numerous gashes along its body. Multiple organs clung to many of the spikes sticking out from its body. Parts of scales have been scraped away, exposing muscle underneath, and some parts of the muscle looked like they had been eaten, leaving bones sticking out. It flopped around and gasped air for a while. Disturbing, gurgling sounds emitted from its mouth. I screamed when I saw the vile creature. Brother turned to me as if he had heard me and grinned. He slowly climbed down from the rock, taking as much time as possible to let the wretched creature suffer much more. He started to eat the Magikarp while I was still alive. I screamed again and covered my mouth as my eyes were forced to watch this gruesome sight. Once he was done, he turned back to me and smiled, a happy, playful smile. Couldn't believe the monster was once my close virtual friend. After that traumatizing event, Brother cheerfully skipped along the beach back to the bus stop singing. This merriment made the situation all that much more horrifying. While waiting for the Mount Snowfall bus, Brother stood in the middle of the walkway staring at me. His face was blank and showed no signs of emotion, even though I knew he couldn't hear me. I whispered, "Why are you doing this?" A tear started to fall down my face. Brother made this world to please you. My blood turned to ice when that message appeared at the top of the screen. Brother casted me another sick, wicked grin that stretched from cheek to cheek. More tears started to sneak past down my face. The Mount Snowfall bus finally arrived. I don't know if I was happy at the sight or petrified at the thought of facing another gruesome scene. Same things as before. Innocent transitions, not so innocent sights. Frostbitten carcasses were strewn out ungloriously across the frozen land, most half buried in snow. Surprisingly, there was no blood or entrails laying about. This area was more of a sad atmosphere than morbid. Brother slowly walked over where a Kecleon and Jigglypuff would normally sing. But since they were dead and buried under the snow, who knows where he took their place. Brother sang the most beautiful, yet saddest song I've ever heard. His harmonious voice sounded like the violins playing the most tear-jerking tune I've ever heard. He had a depressed and sorrowful yet focused expression while he sang the tune, which is just what the song sounded like. I couldn't control the tears that started flooding down my face when he sang. My poor emotional heart broke in two listening to the sorrow-drenched melody. After what seemed like an eternity, Brother finally finished. He looked at me dead straight in the eyes with most sorrowful, depressed, and utterly hopeless expression anyone had ever seen. I longed so much to hold him in my arms and comfort him, but he quickly turned away and ran towards the second half of Mount Snowfall. We stood in front of the ruins of truth. For many moments, Brother just stood dead, still while staring at the ruins. Then he glanced at me, a deep, meaningful look in his eyes, and ran inside. It was jet black inside, like it was supposed to be. He used a thunderbolt to light the electric flowers that caused the entire ruins to light up. All along the walls, ceiling, any floors, many different words and blood were written, "Help me. Why? I must die. Kill me. It's so cold. I'm so lonely. Where is she? Come back. Why can't I die?" Brother walked over to the other side of the ruins, where the true or false tablet stood. I was forced to click on it. Brother was abandoned by his friend years ago and replaced by a new best friend, and was left to rot alone in a virtual world. True or false? I finally understood what all of this meant. All of the words written on the walls, they were from Brother. This was all my fault. I left him, my best friend, to die alone. No, he couldn't even die if he wanted to. He was forced to drag out this miserable existence over the years. I didn't blame him for wanting revenge on me. I deserved this. I slapped myself across the face. What was I thinking? Brother and Pokemon Channel was just a game? I wasn't supposed to devote my life to them. They were only meant to be created to amuse and entertain the mind of a child. They weren't real. I took a minute to ponder over my last statement. They weren't real. I thought about all the things Brother had done to traumatize me and get revenge for abandoning him for so long. Hell, this was all just too real. I selected O for true. It's because I admitted to abandoning him and leaving him alone to rot instead of, I don't know, doing the right thing. It glowed as if it had approval from me. The screen slowly faded to black, except for Brother. He stood in the center of the screen with a tired, angry, yet sad expression. I didn't know what to think of him anymore. I hated him and wished I could really kill him, but I felt sorry and wanted to help him make things better. Brother feels the same way about you. Those messages don't shock me anymore. If anything, I was expecting it. After a few long moments of just staring at each other, I finally started to lose it. "What are you gonna do now?" I asked. "Brother wants you to suffer the same way he did," the game answered. He casted me one last wicked grin, the widest and most grotesque I've ever seen, and the screen cut to black. After a moment, the title screen appeared, and the continue button was gone. I sighed in relief that this horrifying reunion was over. I got up and looked at my desk. On it was a Pikachu Doll Z.